In the series of videos, we have been discussing about the transcription in prokaryotes. And we also discussed about the proteins and enzymes in eukaryotic transcription. If you want to watch that video first, the link is in the description. Now, in this video, we'll be discussing about the transcription initiation in eukaryotes. Before we get into the detailed mechanism, we know it is the RNA polymerase 2 that transcribes all protein-coding genes. And for this transcription, we also need several general transcription factors called the transcription factors 2. That includes transcription factor 2 D, A, B, F, E, H. These are the 6 general transcription factors. Now let's get into the transcription initiation. Here in this diagram, we can see we have a DNA molecule having Tata box and a transcription start point. There are several other consensus sequences on DNA molecule, of which this Tata box is one of the most important sequences of promoter. Other sequences are shown in the diagram displayed here. You can watch the complete video of eukaryotic promoter linked in the description. Going forward now, we see we have a transcription factor 2D first in the run. It has got TBP region, that's Tata binding protein. This TBP region is able to recognize Tata box. And this recognition of Tata box is aided by another transcription factor called the transcription factor 2A. So from here, transcription factor 2D recognizes the Tata box on DNA and binds to it as shown in the diagram. And binding of TF2D to the Tata box recruits another transcription factor, that's TF2B, which comes in and joins the complex also. Now we have RNA polymerase enzyme shown in the diagram below, which marks its entry along with the transcription factor 2F. The RNA polymerase and transcription factor 2F is recruited to the complex by TF2B. And finally, we have another two factors, that's TF2E and TF2H. And among these two factors, first of all, TF2E joins in. And then this E factor in turn recruits transcription factor 2H. This TF2H is important transcription factor, since it has ATPase activity as well as helicase activity. It unwinds DNA at start point and also phosphorylates the CTD of RNA polymerase 2. We see this CTD of RNA polymerase has dynamic phosphorylation throughout the transcription process. As shown in the diagram, we see at initiation stage, serine 5 is phosphorylated only, which recruits capping enzyme. Whereas during elongation, serine 5 as well as serine 2 is phosphorylated. And at the end, that means during termination, only serine 2 is phosphorylated. Now let's get back to the mechanism of transcription. We see unwinding has occurred due to transcription factor 2H, which gives us open form of DNA as shown in the diagram. The assembly of RNA polymerase 2 with the 6 general transcription factors constitutes as the minimal pre-initiation complex, minimal PIC. There are other regulatory transcription factors which regulate the transcription, like we have CBF, CRAB, SP1, as shown in this table. Moreover, to drive the transcription further, nucleotides are added to the transcription machinery, where first of all some factors disassemble and then this polymerase can initiate the transcription. The RNA polymerase 2 moves forward on 3' to 5' strand and synthesizes RNA molecule by the help of elongation factors. So this is how the transcription is initiated in the eukaryotes by RNA polymerase enzyme along with the transcription factors. I hope you like the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. Do consider supporting my work on Patreon and also make sure to subscribe this channel. Thanks.